Good morning and welcome to studio vlog number two. I'm going to continue unpacking my boxes and organizing this craft room and also adding some wall decorations. Come join me. I'm Barbara. I live in Vienna, Austria, and I'm a full-time junk journal artist and digital creator.
Look, it's fixed. Hubby was able to screw this on a bit tighter. So now my shelves fit and my drawers fit. Yay! I'm just missing one drawer right here because that's the one I added on the other side when I changed this arrangement. But I'm pretty sure I have an extra one somewhere. I'm not 100% sure, but if not, I will find a different solution. Maybe I can just slide papers into one of these without having a box. But now I can finally finish setting up my craft supplies. So I'm hoping I can get rid of all of my boxes. So let's start unpacking. So these are napkins. You think I have enough? So I had one box for wintry napkins, of which I have quite a lot. So they get their own box. Look how cute these are. Also love these mushrooms. I love these as well. I often get questions about where I find my napkins, and I must say I find most of them locally by chance, just walking around the city. A lot of our stores that have paper products have stands outside with napkins. Yeah, these aren't so great, but they're okay. These are tissues. They're absolutely adorable. And these are the ones I've already torn bits out of. And then I have a lot for this box, all the non-Christmas themed ones. I think I'll add these to the more wintry Christmassy ones because there's more space in that one, and I think those could go well with the wintry theme. And then I have a lot here which are partially from beautiful Happy Mails. Some of these are mine and I've already torn them. And then again, I have these tissue kind. Then all of my washi tape. What a joy to see all these again. This next box is for all of my ribbons.
So satisfying.
And I also found all of my book parts, mixture of cover, fabric, and spines, and things like that. And they all go into this brick box, which sits on top of my journal bookshelf. Look how yummy these are. Oh, just perfect for collages. And this here is just fabric torn off of vintage book covers. Usually you can just tear it right off. Makes beautiful collage pieces. Some of these I've stitched on by hand, ready to go for collaging. This is a spine fabric, another vintage book spine, another one. Look, I'm so in love with these pieces. To think that most people would just throw these out makes my heart bleed. I understand that it looks like rubbish to most people. But if you're here, then you get it. And even these punched out circles from book fabric can be used in collages. So yummy!
This is my favorite place in my new craft room, I think, with the journals and these wooden boxes. Ah, so in love.
That makes one more empty box. Yes, progress. Next is this full box. This is also where I have my new storage boxes for my stamps. I have had a lot of comments on these with very mixed feelings. Some of you have suggested to add the Tim Holtz ones to the lid so that they wouldn't float around. But the problem with Tim Holtz stamps is they don't cling very well. So for example, see this? See? It won't even stick. So I'm just going to keep them here like this for now. I had various other ideas on storage. I've in the meantime ordered 12 more of these boxes, so I think I'm going to go with that solution. Some of you also commented that you have tried this kind of storage solution without using the acetate that they come mounted on, and that you've ruined your stamps that way, that somehow by sticking them here, you've ruined them. I don't know, why would they get ruined? I mean, the only thing I could imagine is maybe that they lose their stickiness, but I wouldn't even know why that should happen. But why would they get ruined? I don't really get that. So I'm kind of unsure of how to handle these now, because now I'm scared. I don't want to ruin my stamps, obviously. I'll just leave these for now and deal with them when the other boxes come. I reserved a whole square in my bookshelf to stack all of these. So in total there will be 14, and I could label them here on the side, and that way I should be able to find them easily, and or obviously leave the ones that I use most on top. Well, we'll see how that works. I think I had one drawer for all of my smaller wooden stamps, and I had these vellum sheets in here to protect the drawer. Then I have another box for my larger wooden stamps, as well as these two borders. They are both French, and I got these at a craft flea market a few years ago. Pretty much all of my bigger wooden stamps are bought used from craft fairs, not craft fairs, craft flea markets, except this one. This one was custom made for me in Egypt by my very kind friend Eman. Hi Eman, in case you're watching, I adore this stamp so much. And this is of course a self-made one where I just added some washers onto this block, both of which I got at a hardware store. This makes a beautiful stamp. And these are not actually stamps, but I use them as such. At least some of the numbers that work backwards as well. These are the number blocks by Tim Holtz. And then I have this drawer for my vintage stamps and stamp sets. So for example, I have this beautiful vintage Egyptian box. And inside I have some of these stamps that I don't use that often. And I have this number set I don't use that often either. I have these small numbers. I have this small alphabet. More numbers. These came in a Your Creative Studio box once, which is a monthly subscription box. In this box, I have some vintage number stamps. If you are in need for a place to find beautiful vintage junk journal supplies, I will link you one of my favorite shops from Sharika. She is currently situated in the Netherlands. Check out her Instagram feed. She has sales and she also has a very cool advent calendar. So check that out. I don't know if they're sold out by the time you see this video, but definitely worth checking out. She collects beautiful goodies from all of Europe. These are really adorable stamp sets. I have never seen these online, otherwise I would link them. They are by a company called DJECO, and they're just adorable. I find them in shops here. I have to show you. Look how adorable these are. They're so cute. And they're excellent quality. Look at this adorable tea set. That's this pink one. And finally, there's a birthday one. This is my least favorite, but it has some really cool numbers. What I love about these numbers is they are distressed. I don't know how well you can see that, but they actually stamp distressed, so I really love those. Some random like date stamps and planner stamps. This is a beautiful Chinese one. Very heavy. Then one of my absolute favorites, my 12-digit roller stamp, which has letters and numbers. So I would not advise this stamp for everybody because you have to turn these wheels. And for example, when you have to turn something in the middle, it's kind of hard to just turn the one wheel without turning the two next to it because they are so close together. And also you have to line these up quite well. So I always make like a trial stamp before I use it on my actual project because you really need to fiddle around a bit if you want them aligned well. But I still love it because it's so versatile. And I have this cutesy here, which came in one of the Your Creative Studio boxes. It's a date stamp, and I just love that it has its own little wooden like holder thingy. Unfortunately, it's too tall to go like this in my box, so I have to store them separately. I know I should have it on my desk. I just don't have enough space on my desk. In here is a special little dish. I inherited this from my parents, and in here I have a selection of some beads and small bits that I have on my desk usually so that they're ready to go for decorating. Next is my drawer for collage, fodder, and wallpaper scraps, which I have really weeded out before I moved. I took everything out that I knew I would never use. So now I'm quite low on collage fodder. Look at this. This is like nothing. But every single piece in here is a piece that I love and I know I'm going to use at some point. And it's good to have a little bit of space for future collage fodder pieces. This one here is for my neutral scraps. I have also weeded through these before I packed up, and now it's only half full, which makes me happy because again, I know that I will use the pieces that I have in here. In these pouches, I have items that go into these two drawers, and I know they're both pretty full, so this is going to be challenging. So this was a drawer for my watercolors and my wax seals and wax seal stamps. And I know these fit in only in a very specific way. Can I figure out how that worked? I don't know. I feel like I'm playing Tetris. I think I got it. And this drawer was mostly for clamps, like fold back clamps and random bits and pieces. Again, I don't remember how everything fits together. Here I have some wax seals. I don't know how this worked. How did I manage to put it all in here? And some random parts like sharpeners. Going back to our clear boxes, I have one for vintage book pages, and I just have to show you this one. Seeing something like this, I think, is very shocking today. So it's obviously from a German vintage magazine. And the question is for the readers, welche Mädchen sind die hübschesten? Meaning, which girls are the prettiest? I mean, can you imagine a page like this in a current magazine? I definitely cannot. And I've also weeded this down quite a bit. So now they fit in that drawer nicely. Then I had my cool drawer where all of the cool documents get to hang out together. This is where I keep my vintage receipts and various beautiful documents. Some of these I have scans of in my shop. Some I think I still need to scan. Very hard to use the originals even if I have scans. I just love these. Then I have one box for all of my special Tim Holtz supplies. I got all of this, actually it's not only Tim Holtz, it's Tim Holtz and vintage US supplies. I got pretty much all of this from a wonderful soul called Debbie. Incredibly, she had gifted me all of this. And I know she must have paid a fortune just for shipping, let alone the value of all these amazing goodies. But she couldn't craft anymore, and she sent it all to me. I'm still in shock. They're such beautiful things, and I really treasure them. I do have a video of the unpacking of that box. It was so special. I was crying. So if you want to see that, you can find that video linked below in the description box. So she also sent me this beautiful Tim Holtz tissue paper. Love it so much. And just all kinds of goodies. Some of these I know you can't even buy anymore. These are the milk caps. Tim Holtz paper dolls. These are all sitting Tim Holtz paper dolls, and these were sent to me by lovely Terry. Hi Terry, in case you're watching. They have been waiting for a really long time for a very special journal I wanted to make, which I was challenged to do after last Defemorember, because I used some of these sitting paper dolls to sit on top of animals. And then someone had the idea, was it Louisa? Maybe it was Louisa. Louisa, I'm sorry if I don't remember this correctly. Someone suggested that I make a journal only with the sitting Tim Holtz paper dolls on animals. I had mentioned that I don't have enough of the sitting ones. So Terry just kindly sent me these, and they're still waiting for their journal. I'm so sorry, Terry, that I have not made that yet. One day it will happen. And there's these lovely found relatives cards. So these are images of cabinet cards. I have given a lot of these away already. Love these. There's some safety pins. They're called trinket pins. Then there's ring fasteners in small and hex fasteners. Word bands. And various metal charms and some chains, some clasps. Such a treasure. And then there's two salvaged dolls here that are still waiting for a special project. Then I have a whole bunch of beautiful Happy Mail items. I had a box that was completely overflowing. So I think I can now afford to put these into two boxes because I got rid of one of them in which I had all my dies and my embossing folders, which are now in a different place. So that makes my life easier, but I still need to make one or two happy mail journals soon. I could honestly cry when I see all these beautiful things that you have sent me. Then I had this pile here, which is a mixture of wallpaper, packaging, paper bags, and random bits and pieces. And this is what I will put in the cabinet without the drawer. Hopefully I can still find a drawer, but if not, I can just slide these in there because they're big enough and they won't get lost. My second to last drawer was for packaging. So I have all kinds of paper bags and envelopes. Also clear packaging. Some new, some used. And finally, this last drawer was for all my clear stamps, which will be moved into the clear storage containers. But until they get here, I will store them in here. We have another empty box. Yes. And guess what? I just found two more completed journals and a journal cover that has nothing inside yet. I will have to find space on my journal bookshelf. These here are journals that are not completed, that I'm still working in. And these two are covers. I'll still need to add something to. Have I mentioned how happy this shelf makes me? Okay, so I'm still rearranging. My room looks a bit of a mess right now, but I'm hoping it's the ugly stage before the pretty stage. As you can see, there are things everywhere. I did manage to get rid of another box, which was here in the corner. And my current thought process is the following. This, as you can see, is no longer turned upside down. This is where my sewing machine was previously. Because of your comments, I decided that I need my sewing machine to be very easily accessible. And although I could just, you know, have it here and then I'm sitting there and I could just turn around here, I again would have the cable situation. So instead, I decided that I'm going to make this table my sewing table. So my sewing machine is under here. I have the plugs in the back and I will put some boxes or something here where I can keep some sewing accessories easily accessible. Accessories accessible. Yep. Then that also solves another problem I have. So I have a free space down here now where my die cut machine is, and I will tell you in a moment where that's going to go. That solves the problem that I didn't have a place to put my printer paper and printer toner. So that can all go down there. And then Obviously, on top here, I can keep everything that I use on a very regular basis so that I have it by my desk, and I can also roll the trolley over to the other side, which will be the place where I film. So my plan is do the filming here, do the computer work there. So you see here my setup. Actually, this clamp will go on this side here, usually when I film, but the lights will stay there. And I will link those lights for you. I have them from Amazon Germany. I will link them for you from the Amazon Germany store, but in English, so you can check those out. Those are really great. And I probably can link one of these clamps as well. They work for mobile phones and iPads. They're really cool. You can bend them in any way you want, and they are very stable. I love these. And then the other idea is I still have a glass table, which is, I hope I'm not turning too fast, this one here. So this is completely glass. And then it has these metal legs, which are here. So I'm thinking I could have that desk here. I wasn't sure yet whether I really want to close everything up, but I really think I need the space. Like, I need the surface space. So once I have that, I can put things on there, like, for example, my die cut machine, which is currently here on the floor. And what I was trying out is, because I have this beautiful wooden box that I found at my Goodwill once. So it's a tea box, obviously. It's not that vintage, but it looks really nice. I added some Tim Holtz paper over whatever was there. I don't remember, but it wasn't pretty. And then I just put my Tim Holtz dies here. The ones that are, you know, the thicker ones that never fit into anything. Then I also have my plates here for the die cut machine. So that can go on to the glass desk together with the die cut machine. And I'm sure I'll have plenty of other things laying around that need to go on that desk. Then I've hung this thing up. I got this from Dahab in Egypt on my last trip to Egypt in June. So these are all little metal elements with little bells and beads. I'm such a sucker for all of these dangly things, whether it's on a journal or on the wall. I just always love it. So that's there. And on my opposite wall next to my door, I have this, which I embroidered about 30 years ago, probably. I did have the help of my mom. I guess these are cherry blossoms or apple blossoms. I'm not even sure, cherry or apple. You see how well I know my plants. But I remember this was a lot of work, and I really love how it came out. This was also just sitting in a box for decades, so super happy with that. So I have to wait for my hubby to have some time to put that table here. And then you see here, I have some other things I was planning on hanging. I actually don't think I will be able to fit everything, but I thought I could hang this happiness thing here in gold. Here, on top of my journals. And that can then just be very minimalistic. So that would go on the wall right there. I think that would look cute because I don't want to clutter up the whole room either. I want it to be kind of airy. I also bought this thing here, which has hooks on it. And I thought this would look really nice in my craft room, but now I don't know what to put on the hooks. Obviously, I didn't think it through. Theoretically, it could go here, I guess. But what would I put on the hooks? Sure, I could put like scissors and things like that, but those would be too far away from my craft desk. So I would need to put something there that is more for decorative purposes than for being useful. I also have this cute key. Love the white distressed look. I have no idea where to put this. I mean, I could hang it either like this or like this. Don't know yet where to put that, so that will be on hold for now. Okay, so what do we think about this happiness sign here? It's very minimalistic, isn't it? Okay, I'm going to see how I like it, maybe change it for something more substantial. Then I also bought this beautiful framed antique jewelry in Dahab, Egypt. I bought this mainly because I wanted to use it as inspiration, because you see here I have two other beautiful jewelry pieces. My mom bought these when they lived in Saudi Arabia. So I think I could do something similar with both of these to put them in a frame like this. I think that really looks pretty. And I thought I could put this one next to my mom's portrait by the printer right there. I think that would look nice. Okay, what do we think? We like? I think I like it. And another piece I bought in Dahab, Egypt was this beautiful metal tree, again with bells. So cute. And I think I'm going to hang that up right here next to the printer as well. So that will make the printer corner a more cozy one. So that's what my printer corner now looks like. And I think it's so much better than it was before. Really cozy. Mwah! Mwah!